Hello, well done.
Gosh, I got a bit teary up there.
Fair enough, though.
I did.
What was the moment where you started tearing up?
Oh, just at the end when I thanked my parents and Alice, because my parents were there tonight, and I bought them tickets, and they were sitting on the front row, and it was just really nice. And I forgot a whole chunk of my speech because I didn't take up. I said I could do it without autocue, and I said I could do it without notes, because normally that's what I do, and I forgot the whole bit in the middle about all the talented people who support me.
Say it now.
I would like to thank all the incredibly talented people at the BBC and Channel 4 who make me look like I know what I'm talking about, and I would share this with all of them, but if it's okay, I'll keep it at my house.
Definitely. Were you surprised the Paralympic Games won?
Yeah, that was brilliant. What a brilliant result. So pleased for them. Yeah. So pleased for all of us that worked on it. Because I think Channel 4 were really bold with the way they went about it. And, you know, from the publicity campaign beforehand, the posters and the trailers that went out, this whole superhumans thing, I just thought it was stunningly well done. And they really brought alive characters that we don't see much of and we don't see enough of in live sport. So you wouldn't have known beforehand who Johnny Peacock was or Hannah Cockcroft. You'd have known Ellie Simmons, but with a lot of the others, you know, Channel 4 made them matter. And that's the key to live sport. We've got to make you care. Because if you don't care about the people involved, then what's the point? You might as well play a video game, I think.
Absolutely, yes.
Yes.
Moment of covering the Olympics?
Well, I mean, loads of sporting moments, but I think sort of away from the actual result, Chad's dad, Bert, he was a gift. He was an absolute gift, and I'm so grateful to Mark Foster, who went and got him, and to the security man who let him through. And he was unbelievable, as he would say. And that's what I mean about, you know, there's a 20-year-old South African who's just beaten Michael Phelps in a race Michael Phelps hasn't been beaten in 7 years. And Chad's dad, Bert, made that come alive for you. He made that you feel what he was feeling. And those are the moments that you just can't plan for those. No. You have to hope that they happen, try and help them happen, and then shut up when the guy's there and just hold a microphone in front of his face. Actually, I think this Olympic Games, if you take the lineup of this Olympic Games, Hazel Irvine to Michelle Hussein, handing over to Sue Barker, handing over to me at the swimming, Jill Douglas at the cycling, and Gabby Logan doing the highlights, that is a damn good lineup. And I'm just really chuffed to be a part of a team that strong. You know, they're really good, and they're specialists in different areas, but they're good general sports presenters as well. So I think we're probably living in the strongest era ever of female sports presenters, and I think you need a generation that is strong to help inspire the, you know, 9, 10, 11-year-olds now who look at this and think, oh, I could do that, and I want to do that. I don't get sick of it. I love it, and I love the fact every time they want to talk about it, they smile. And that's just great, because I think it was more than a sporting event. It was an incredibly powerful shared event for the nation, and I think it helped us restore confidence in ourselves. And I think also it helps you be really positive. And actually, that I know that most of the time we're writing stories, you're writing stories that are having, you know, your editor wants something that's having a bit of a go. What actually was wonderful about the Olympics and Paralympics is you didn't even have to do that. That it was all about positive energy. It was all about being part of the same team, working towards the same goal, and looking at people who were defying the odds, you know, who were achieving excellence, mainly through damned hard work, not because they wanted to be famous, just because they were working really hard and they wanted more than anything to be the best that they could be. And if that's good enough to win a gold medal, then hurrah. I'm not sure about the national treasure tag. I was in America recently, and a journalist from the Wall Street Journal said, I read that you're a national treasure. Is that something that's given by the government? I said, no, I don't believe so. This is incredible, because this is an award that is given in the name of Richard Dimbleby, who was the great all-round presenter of his era and the one of the greatest in the history of British broadcasting. So that means a huge amount. And even more so to know, and I didn't before I won it, that it's not awarded every year. I think it was last awarded in 2006, and Jamie Oliver won it. Kate Adie has won it. Jon Snow has won it.
Legends.
Yeah, and to be a sports presenter on that list is just a real joy. I'm so proud. I'm so chuffed. I'm a little bit embarrassed to be singled out amongst a wealth of really good broadcasting talent on both games. But you know, damn pleased it was me. Well, my dream job was last summer, and that's the thing. That is an award that says, you know, that kind of recognises the highlight of my career, of anyone's career who worked on it. And that, to me, is an incredible accolade I didn't think I would get, that sort of brings to an end that era, that the Games of 2012 are now officially closed for me. And it's up to me now to think like an Olympian or a Paralympian and plan for the next event and say, right, what next? What do I want to do? How do I keep challenging myself, push myself out of my comfort zone, keep being intellectually challenged as well, which is important for me. And most of all, keep doing what I love, because I think it's awfully easy to sometimes get seduced by lots of other things, but the most important thing to me, the absolute core of what I, the choices I make, is do it because you love it. And that makes such a difference. No, I can't sing and I don't want an album deal. That's a very kind thought though, that's lovely. And I can't dance either. And no, I can't bake. There's so many things I can't do. So I'll try and stick to what I can do. And, you know, I'm very lucky. I've got, you know, a job starting with BT Sport doing a once a week chat show, which will be a sports chat show. And that will be a real thrill and involved creatively with that as well. And also obviously doing Channel 4 Racing and Radio 2 and different programmes on the BBC. So I'm blessed. I don't need and indeed I'm not searching for any more stimulation in terms of presenting. I don't know yet, but I think smack bang in the middle of the mantelpiece. I think that's where it should go. Yes. And for the team that I forgot to thank on stage, they're very welcome to visit it any time they want. I will keep it polished, I promise. And I think, you know, last summer was particularly strong in terms of female imagery, of seeing female athletes doing well, being allowed to be seen to be ambitious and competitive and strong. And I think that does make a massive difference. And women's cycling is huge now. Women's rowing is huge, and we're very good at it. Equestrian has always been very gender equal. And I think it is about finding sports. I mean, for me, the key to the kingdom is women's football. I think women's football can be huge, and I've said it plenty of times before. And BT have just signed up to do the Women's Super League, and I know the BBC are doing the international games. And I don't present women's football, so I say this with no vested interest at all, but that is the most popular sport in this country, and that's the one that I think can reach the most people, and that we should be very, very good at, and have chances of winning European Championships and World Cups, and that's great.
But do you actually support Arsenal women's team?
No, I don't, Boyd, sorry.
Well, you should. thank you so much, Clayborne.
Thank
legendary Clayborne.
Thank you.
Thank you.